We're not doing that.
Hi, dear.
Not doing that. Hey.
What you doing?
Getting ready to set up to make some cookies for the kids and for me. I've been wanting to bang on cookies for the last couple of days. And we're going to make some chocolate chip cookies.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking for all my measuring tools, and y'all can get set up. So basically, you're going to need 2 sticks of unsalted butter is what I use. I'm looking at my recipe now. Some all-purpose flour, baking soda, salt, granulated sugar, and golden brown sugar, and pure vanilla extract, and 2 large eggs, and some milk chocolate or semi-sweet morsels, the little chocolate chips. Mm. Let me preheat the oven to 375.
Uh-huh.
All right, so that's going to be warming up. Now, I got my 2 sticks of butter, so this will equal up to be 1 cup of butter. I'm going to go ahead. It's supposed to be softened at room temperature, but I just decided to make cookies, so these are straight out of the refrigerator. To get them to be softened, I'm going to put them in the microwave for on defrost for 2 minutes.
Yep.
So let's do that. I don't never use the defrost. Let's see. Okay. 2:00. Okay. So we got that defrosting. Let's get the measuring cups. Baby, you know what my I think it's up there. The 1 cup measuring. Can you get it for me?
Yeah, you can put all of that.
Okay. Thank you. It's perks to having a tall man, but you got to buy me a new measuring cup, honey bunny.
Keep kids away from your stuff.
I know they always break up my stuff. Jesus. But see, I like to teach them to cook, though. You know, that's, so that's nice. Okay. So we, as far as the all-purpose flour, we're going to need 2 of these.
We're getting likes. We have to 50 likes so far. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you guys for your likes. Baby, do you know where my, my green scooper is? The one-fourth scoop?
No.
Yeah.
Uh-uh.
Is it in the dishwasher? Can you move this over there?
Okay, look, I'm supposed to be doing cameras.
I know, but we were just in here cleaning up earlier. Ooh, that's hot. And I just decided randomly that I wanted to make some chocolate chip cookies, which this happens a lot.
Well, the benefit is that you're doing it in a clean kitchen.
It is very clean. Oh, my God. I got the walls clean. Okay, never mind. We're not talking about clean right now. We're talking about chocolate chip cookies. Hope. All right. My 1/4 cup is missing. These kids just keep taking all my stuff. Wait, my 1/4 cup is missing. Okay, so what do we do when we're missing a measuring cup?
Okay, well, you improvise.
Okay, so what can we do to make 1/4 cup?
Well, 1/4 is really half of 1/2. So you could just use the 1/2 cup, but just fill it halfway.
So we could use this 1/2 cup.
Right. Fill the 1/2 cup halfway, and that'll be your 1/4.
Okay, well, we're going to do it. We're going to try it. Okay, thank you, baby. Mm. Okay, so I'm going to start putting the flour in this bowl. This is a small mixing bowl, and then you want to use the sifter. The sifter is going to blend all these dry ingredients together. So that's done, but let me do this. So we need, let me get me a butter knife. Okay, so I'm going to use the back of this butter knife to make it smooth so it can be leveled. But that 1/4 cup thing is going to be tricky, but we're going to try it. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so when you pull out the flour, if I had my handle on mine, it would be right. But this is how it might look. So you want to take the back of the knife, and you want to knock that flour off. You want to make it as level as you possibly can. You see that? You see how level that is? And let's dump it in.
Level. True level.
So we need to do that again. And this is kind of fun. I'm gonna have to put my apron on. That's why I normally have my apron on in some of my videos. I need my apron, honey.
You don't need no apron.
Well, I don't want to get my clothes.
I'll be cooking with apron all out, apron all the time.
I know you be making some delicious meals. Shout out to you, honey buddy. He be making some chicken and waffles, y'all. Oh my god. Oh shoot, I think I just knocked too much out. Oh, okay, Lord. Hold on, y'all. See, this is what happened in the kitchen. You know, when I'm making the videos, I make it look smooth because of the editing, but oh my god, when you're in the kitchen, you make a mess. And trust me, I don't like cleaning it up, but somebody got to do it. You hear me? I made the mess. Okay, there we go. This is the second cup. We made the mess, y'all. Okay, now we're finna do this. You said, since our 1/4 cup is missing, now if you got your 1/4 cup, you use that. But I have to do this hack that Graylin just said because I can't find my 1/4 cup. Scoop, my kids took it somewhere. Okay, so you said to do what with this 1/2 of a cup?
So you take the 1/2 a cup.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the half cup, you just fill it up halfway.
Halfway.
That'll make it 1/4.
So let's see. I think I got a trick to make it level. Hold on. Because we ain't going to be able to use the back of the butter knife, right? Because that's just going to make it 1 cup. So let's try. I'm going to try to see if I can. No, that ain't going to fit. Let's see if this works. Oh, that ain't going to fit either. So how we going to do it? I'm going to knock some of it out. Let's see. Now, like I said, if you got your 1/4 cup, you winner to winner. But I got to do this because mine is missing. One of my kids been playing with it, probably the little one. Because he like to come in the kitchen because he always see me in the kitchen. Draxton be everywhere. He try to sweep. He try to mop. He does everything that I do. And I love him for that.
Mm-hmm.
Because that means that he's paying attention to mommy. But oh my God, do all my stuff just get everywhere. Jesus. Okay, back on hand. So we did 2 whole cups and 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour. So we got that sitting in there. The next thing that we need to do, let me get my recipe out. I used to make cookies all the time, but you can't be eating cookies all the time. They got to be a treat. So I wrote the recipe down. Okay.
Yep, that was the recipe.
All right, so we need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Hey, can you get the baking soda out of the refrigerator, honey?
Sure.
Look at my hands. I'm just a flour mess. I'm putting my apron on.
There you go.
Okay. Thank you so much. All right, so we're going to do 1 teaspoon of baking soda. And what song was that? I liked it, that song.
That was that Save That Money song. Remember we was watching all the videos that one night?
Oh, okay. Hey, when we want to have club time, because we have 4 children, so ain't no going to the club. We got to be parents. And I'm old. I mean, not that old. I'm 35, but I'm tired. I get to need my rest, okay? So we have club crib night, and we was watching what we start off with.
I think you wanted to watch the Logic video, Vaccine.
Oh, Logic, Vaccine. And that video was dope. Shout out to Logic. But then we just let it go and play. Oh, my God. We saw some amazing videos. I forgot what it was like to watch music videos. You know, because I ain't did that in a while. But it was nice. Did you have fun, honey?
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah, it was fun. Got to bring the club to home sometime.
Yep. All
right, so we got 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Not baking powder, baking soda. It's the difference on how it will turn out. So don't use baking powder. Make sure it's baking soda.
What the rappers use.
All right, now we need 1 teaspoon of salt, okay? I'm going to do it over the sink. I would have used the regular one, but I don't feel like getting it. Okay, that probably was really lazy, but I'm already into it. Don't yell at the phone. Don't yell at the phone. Don't do that. It's method to my madness. Okay, we're going to put a little bit more on it.
Okay, cuz.
Okay, my bad.
You know, there's like superstitious people watching this. They're like, oh my God. Stop spilling the salt. Stop spilling the salt.
Okay, so
we're going
to put this 1 teaspoon of salt in there. And okay, now what's next? My favorite part.
What's your favorite part?
I get the sift. I really love sifting. Okay, right. Ready? Let's go. Oh man, it's so smoky up in here though. Oh man, I love to sift. Look at that. Look how well blended that is. And it is really oddly satisfying. Okay. All right, now we gotta move on to the next step. We're gonna sit our mixture, our batter here on the side. And now we gotta cream together the butter, the eggs, the sugar, the brown sugar, and the vanilla extract. Okay, so let's go ahead and get our large mixing bowl. Trying to assemble this thing. All right, there we go. Large mixing bowl. Let's get our butter. It should be at room temperature and softened. So this is 2 sticks of unsalted butter, which equals to be 1 cup, okay, of unsalted butter. I'm going to put it in there. All right, perfect. Now we're going to get our sugar.
Oh, yeah, but
this shoot.
What?
I need my 1/4 cup.
Why?
Because I got to put 3 of those in there.
So you need 3/4 cup?
Yeah.
Well, let me see something.
Of that and brown sugar. Let me see. Did you put it in my coffee thing?
What, the 3/4 cup?
Yeah.
No, that's only, hold on.
It was the green one. This the brand new coffee? Yeah, that's how, when you're in a black household, you be having scoops of random things and random items. But when I was growing up,
all right, here, check this out.
What?
It's 12 tablespoons to make 3/4 of a cup.
12 tablespoons?
Yes.
Oh, this is interesting. Okay.
Yeah.
1 whole tablespoon, right?
Right. One. Yeah, so if you do that 12 times, that's going to give you your 3/4 cup.
Okay, so this is the 1 tablespoon. Look how big it is.
Right, and if people
so
think
if
I'm lying.
So if we do this 12 times.
Yeah. See? How many tablespoons, 3/4 cup? So in 3/4, there are 12 tablespoons. Okay. Google it. Use your conversion. Use your tools.
Okay, so we're going to do this.
Yeah.
Now, we know how my cookies normally turn out with the right utensils, but we're going to try this and see if it turns out the same. So, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, so someone says if you have 1/4 cup, do that 3 times. We would like to, but we don't have the 1/4 cup, so we got to do the tablespoon 12 times. But thank you so much.
5.
Thank you, Joy. We appreciate that.
Don't yell at the phone.
I'm not yelling. I said thank you.
I'm talking about you.
I said that, yes. See, we got little people running around here taking our stuff, so we got to improvise. Thank God for Google.
Man, thank God for Google. We should have asked the Google box.
No.
8, 9.
All right, I want to tell you this though.
10, what?
Somebody, something about some comment earlier, talking about, and this is how they wrote it, is IS smells like diabetes in there. And it doesn't help that he looks like, you know, T.D. Jakes, so you know.
Don't roast them. It's okay.
Okay.
Okay. I think that was clear.
We got a follower. Oh, her name is Joy. Thank you for following.
Hi, Joy. Welcome to the Nash House. All right, so we need to get... Well, you know, to that person that said it smells like diabetes, when you eat any type of cookies, you have to understand that these are the ingredients that are inside of them. This main base of this recipe was based off the Nestle Toll House recipe that I found on, and you can find on the back of the chocolate chips. Now, if these ingredients to you seem fattening, then it's important that anything that you eat, you try to find the root of what's in it. That's why I don't do buttermilk fried chicken on my channel, because we have to eat that. So I'm not going to double dip it in flour because I feel like that's unhealthy. But if I go to a restaurant and order buttermilk fried chicken, I'm going to tear it up because I don't know what's in it. So you have to know when you see ingredients like this and you think that this is diabetes, this is like any other cookie that you ate in the store when you were growing up or if you still eat cookies. No different. But this is how you make chocolate chip cookies from scratch. And if Oh, go ahead, honey.
No, keep going.
Oh, no, 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 no. And if you get them still and they're prepackaged, just understand there's even more of that in those cookies. All these ingredients, if they seem fattening, just imagine prepackaged cookies have even more of this in it.
Bars!
All right, that's enough of that. I need to get back to what I was doing. I was trying to find my brown sugar. All right.
The brown sugar?
Yeah, the brown sugar. So this is what a black person house is. You got items that you sit and stuff in to make sure that it gets sealed and it don't go bad. That's somebody calling and we don't know.
And we don't care.
And we don't care.
The ignore button is my best friend.
Hey, you know, because I get paid to do this content. This is my job. So if I don't really want to talk, that's okay. I can be live anytime. You hear me? Okay, so the brown sugar is, because we ain't made cookies in a while, so it's kind of stale. How do we get it from being in a ball?
I don't know.
You got to ask Google.
What? I just took Google out.
Well, I need you to ask Google, honey, because I didn't plan on making this. I just decided to.
Well, I planned on playing the game, but here we are.
Oh, what game you want to play? You want to play Frozen?
No.
But I really like that game.
I ain't playing no doggone Frozen.
Come on, let's...
Wait. Oh, here comes Joy. In the clutch, you can melt it.
How do you melt it?
How?
Because this thing, I've been over here trying to squish it. My strength ain't what it used to be, but dang, this mug is the strongest.
Okay. To properly melt brown sugar,
okay,
pour it into a microwave-safe bowl.
Okay.
Partially fill another bowl with water.
Okay.
This will help keep the sugar moist, especially if it's hardened some and starting to get dry. Next, microwave both bowls at the high heat for 30 seconds.
Okay. So we fill this bowl with some water.
So
okay, that should be enough. And then let's put this in there like that?
No, but you do it separately.
Mm-hmm.
Both bowls go in the microwave at the same time.
Okay.
Not inside one another.
Oh! Okay!
Well, it doesn't say put it inside one another.
I thought that would be it. I'm going to try it. Does that make sense to me? Hold on.
Okay.
Well, this is like science. I really like science. So what do you put it on?
30 seconds.
30 seconds.
Just okay. Press quick start.
Okay. Tommy, you all in the way.
Yeah, people all waving. Right. Oh, you, we got another follower, so.
You go ahead and talk to them real quick. I got to.
What?
I got to go to the bathroom.
What? Why? I got to talk to them.
Well, they can't talk to me, honey. They can't go to the bathroom with me.
Who says? I can just walk right behind you.
No. I'll be right back.
Oh. Well, what am I supposed to do when this thing get done?
Oh, just leave it there.
Just leave it there. See, I'm the cameraman. I shouldn't have to deal with this. All I'm supposed to do is just point the camera and y'all look at stuff. But no, I got to sit here and talk to y'all. So, how's that Super Bowl? Yeah, a lot of people join. Oh, we got a lot of people on here. 38. Yeah, hurry up. It's got more people looking. Hurry up. See, that's why I don't do live. Because stuff be happening like this. And she walked off. I don't know what she expect me to do. I can't make no cookies and point the camera. I mean, I could try it, but it's not going to be now. Oh, there she is.
Wait a minute.
What?
I got to dry my hands. Hold on. I don't want them to see me with my hands like this.
Yep. Okay, for those of y'all that missed it, we sifted these ingredients right here. So this stuff got sifted.
That's all the dry ingredients.
Now
so
I'm about to do...
That's the flour, the baking soda, and the salt. All blended well. So we put this in the microwave because they said we can melt it. But we're going to try it. It's softened up just a little bit. You know what? risk it all. This has been an experiment anyway. We just gonna dump this all in there. That look like it's about 12 scoops. If y'all can see Graylin's face, we risking it all for TikTok Live. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, you know what, dude? Might have been right. This might be some diabetes.
Okay.
Well, you know what? It ain't the white sugar.
Okay. Wait a minute. Ooh, yeah. Where's my vanilla extract? Okay, I found it. You got that.
Yeah.
Okay, honey. I need 2 large eggs. You gotta really use your skills to get down there. And keep the camera on me. Okay, this is actually kind of fun. We should do this more often for the people. I normally just bake cookies and we record it and then I edit it. And I think a lot of people just want to get the steps out the way. But you guys actually like me cooking live. You know, I thank you for tuning in. Oh no! Don't tell me! Don't say it! We ain't got no eggs! Oh my god! I'm gonna kill you, Graylin.
Wait. What I gotta do with this?
You the one always making breakfast. You know we ain't got no eggs.
Well, I forgot we. Listen, all I made was pancakes this morning.
Oh, you knew we had no eggs. You had me doing all this and knew I was.
I didn't know we had no eggs.
So, what can we do?
Anybody know a good substitute for eggs?
Oh god, these cookies gonna be like
that's embarrassing. Wait, someone said use applesauce.
Applesauce! Do we have any more applesauce? Oh, we got one. Oh,
Draxton
keep eating up all my applesauce! Ooh! We got one thing of applesauce. Oh, and it's
this is how it goes every time I make cookies, because it's either we can't find anything of what I'm supposed to have, or the utensils are missing, and or we don't have no eggs. So we're gonna take a brief intermission. Okay, I'm gonna take a brief.
Okay, I gotta go get some eggs because we was cooking the cookies and I realized we ain't had no eggs. So I'm finna run up to the store. Man, it's been an adventure today. Jesus, I can't even get out the door. I should have probably took this ponytail down, but maybe people would think I'm crazy and never talk to me. Hold on. Hey, baby.
Hey,
I was finna leave that ponytail up, but I didn't want nobody to think I was crazy, so I'll be right back, Tommy. All right.
Let's go.
So I'm at the local Save-A-Lot, and they have some really cool deals and everything. Okay, we got the eggs. Let's see. $3.29. Okay, I'm gonna get it. I always want to check your eggs though. All right, they look good. All right, let's go. Let y'all see the store. Peaceful in here. Now, this is in Ferguson. It's real peaceful in here. All right. I gotta focus.
I hid Tommy's sweater.
You did hide his sweater.
No, I didn't.
Well, who hid it?
I don't know. I know it wasn't me.
You and Tommy. Y'all
you always talk about, you threw Tommy Wommy's sweater away and I did not like it.
I don't be like when you do that to my Tommy
Wommy. F Tommy Wommy and the set he reps. How about that?
Okay, let's get back to the recipe. So we were doing.
With his dog face, dog looking ass.
Okay. We were doing the vanilla extract. Okay, so we need 1 teaspoon. You come on over. We need 1 teaspoon.
What? Dang, you gonna be that close? Okay. So you wanna put it over the bowl. And pour it like that. All right, that's pure vanilla extract. All right. Man, it's been a while since I did this recipe. All right, now we got to mix it up. Let me wash off the handle
for us. And if those that missed it, we picked up eggs from the store!
Yay!
Look. Eggs.
Save-A-Lot here in St. Louis and Ferguson. So glad that they are in the community. I promise. I can just run up in there and it's nice and peaceful. and get what I need and get out. And the local owner, he's always there. I really like that. Okay, babe, I'm struggling. Okay, I got it.
Well, say, I don't know what you want me to do. I'm holding the camera.
Shut up. You always try to be funny. So you be picking beef with me and Tommy Wami.
Ain't nobody picking no beef with nobody.
All right, so,
especially not no Tommy. That's why he trash. His bark is trash.
Stop talking about my dog.
Well, he the one that bark trash.
Woo! All right,
so we're going to mix this on. There you go. I'm going to pull it out. We're going to mix this on low so it can cream together. Come on over so they can see.
Oh, that ain't low. My bad.
Dough.
All right, let's speed it up. Man, what time is it, babe?
2:13.
Okay, so we ain't got to pick up no kids yet. All right, now this is perfect. We're going to keep it on the 2. I need those eggs. Thank you. I asked you for 2 eggs. I ain't asked you for the whole carton, man.
Well, I had the whole carton in my hand, cuz.
But this is too much for me over here while I'm trying to cook.
Well, just put it in the bowl.
I'm just saying.
There you go. Put it in the bowl. Hand it back to me. There you go. You're welcome.
Shush. Okay, well, I'm going to wait till this next day so they can see it. All right, so here's how I taught my daughter how to crack an egg. All right, so you just want to take a butter knife and hit it like that. And then you can pull it apart. There you go. That's an easy hack, right? That's how I want her to do it, because if I let her do it her way, she's just going to smash the whole thing and then it'll be everywhere. But me, how I like to do it, just put it on there. There you go. All right, let's speed it up, y'all. Let's going to cream it together. And how's the lighting, baby? Can they see?
Oh, they can see.
Okay. And see all that creaming together?
Oh, look at that.
All right, I'm going to get my spatula. Which is this. This is called a spatula. See that? And we're going to turn it off. So we can push some of this butter down that kind of flew around at the top. I want to push it down so it can thoroughly mix. Now this is part of how you make the wet batter of chocolate chip cookies. And the first half we did that. We made the dry ingredients. We blended them together. So now we're going to put them all together to make cookie dough. All right. So since we pushed all that down, we're going to turn it back on.
And y'all see, you know, we got this KitchenAid mixer. It's actually a really good investment.
It really is. I can't wait to buy the attachment to make the pasta.
Ooh.
That's what's next. I want to learn how to make pasta. Because we made some really good pasta dishes. All right, we got that whipped up good. Now we're going to add the dry ingredient. Babe, can you hand me that bowl? I'm going to lower it down.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. So this is all the dry ingredients sifted together. Gosh, it's so hard to get out. Ah! Okay, I did it. Yay.
After having a little rage fit over there.
I didn't have no rage fit. Shut up.
Yeah, you did.
Maybe now. All right, we're going to start it slow, because if you start it too fast, you're going to get a big cloud. I only know that because I did it.
Oh, yeah. No likes in there and show love and all that.
You're so nonchalant. I love it. All right, I'm going to speed it up just a little bit gradually. There we go.
Yeah. Hi, everybody that joined and is watching.
Thank you for tuning in. We're making chocolate chip cookies from scratch. Look at that.
If y'all see take 2 on the title, the reason it's take 2 because to take 1, we realized we ain't had no eggs, so we had to stop the live and go get them.
But I can't reach the chocolate chips. Do not say no funny short jokes. Give me the phone. Can you get the chocolate chips, please?
It doesn't help that you said it like that, neither. Sound like a little kid.
Mm-hmm. calls for 2 cups of the semi-sweet morsels. Now, you can get, this is the Nestle Toll House brand. If you have the regular kind, that's fine. It still will work with this recipe. No problem. All right, so to measure out, we're going to use our measuring cup that we had the butter in earlier.
The butter?
The butter.
Get your mind out the gutter and pass the butter.
All right, here, babe, bring them down here so they can see me pour it in there. That's kind of oddly satisfying. So we want to get it to the 2-cup line. I wish they had slow-mo in capability while you live, but they don't do that. But that's how I would did the video when I was editing it. Okay. It looks right, just about right, right?
Yep.
Look good to me. All right, let's go. All right, so I lowered this KitchenAid tool down so I can get all the dough off. See, that's the cookie dough. If you wanted just sugar cookies, this is your stop point. But if you want chocolate chip cookies or peanut butter chocolate chip cookies or whatever it is that you might want, you add them in at this point. Yeah. Win.
Chocolatey taste in every bite.
You're so funny. All right, so I want all my chocolate chips. And I'm making these for my kids. So when they come home from school, I can surprise them that I made them some cookies because they've been really good for me.
Okay, so somebody said they close Save-A-Lot where they are. Aw, where y'all from?
Yeah, where
they
close from?
Save-A-Lot.
We're here in St. Louis, Missouri. That's sad to hear. I hope they give you a different type of grocery store in your community. That's always important. I like this song.
Hey,
they said you're not supposed to eat cookie dough, but oh my God.
Hey, you know what? So I don't care about that. They put it in ice cream.
Oh my God, it looks so good.
If they put it in ice cream, it must be okay to eat. I don't care what they say.
Oh, look at that. I just want to eat some, y'all. Okay, I'm going to do it. Don't y'all tell nobody to eat no raw dough. Well, I'm going to eat.
It's delicious. They shouldn't be putting it in ice cream then.
Okay.
Oh, okay. We got more people coming in. Thank you so much. And don't be afraid to like. Y'all can like stuff.
Just tap on the screen. It's easy. You just tap on the screen.
You can tap on it once. You can tap on it 100 times.
We appreciate it. And welcome to the Nash House. We're making some chocolate chip cookies for the kids. They've been pretty decent. They do what we ask. They all right. Oh, you got to have some muscles to move this around. Now, the reason why I'm mixing it with my hand, I probably need to use my bigger spatula. Let me get that one.
Yeah.
The reason why you want to mix it with your hand and not the tool is you don't want to accidentally melt your chocolate chips, which will happen. And that's why you need to actually turn it with a spatula.
Okay, we got some followers on there. Thank you.
Thank you for following. Welcome to the Nash House, guys. Y'all always welcome to our house, to our page and our channel. We do have a YouTube also. Okay.
See now this dynamic works right here, how we do stuff. Like, you be on the camera and then like I'll say stuff, kinda like how David Letterman, you know, be talking to his band
and
then the band talk back to him a little bit, but then it's always focused on Letterman.
So see? Who are you David Letterman?
No, you're Letterman. I'm just part of the band.
Oh, okay. Okay, I can't help you. I'm so good. All right. So you
Nurse Icy shared the video. Thank you for sharing,
Thank
Nurse.
You.
Appreciate you.
Oh, no, I need not the ice cream scooper. I need my cookie scooper. So this is a cookie scooper. I found this at Dollar Tree. That was the only place I was able to find it.
For $1.25.
No, not Dollar Tree. I'm wrong. Dollar General.
Yeah, okay, there you go.
It was Dollar General. It was like $2, but it was worth it. I mean, it is like it scoops out the perfect cookie. Watch. Hold on, I'm gonna take this off. Baby, you know I ain't got that much. Okay, I got it. Okay.
There you go.
Okay, let's come over here. You wanna come over here? Okay, so we got this is the silicone mat that you can put on your cookie sheet so you don't have to worry about the mess being on or your cookies actually cooking too hard and they hard on the bottom and burn. You don't have to worry about that with a silicone mat. I got that from Dollar General also. Okay.
I gotta put my waist back up.
All right, so this will scoop out the perfect size. Yes, Draxton. And you just wanna place it right there. Cookies, when you bake them, they don't take no more than 10 minutes. So we're gonna set a timer after we put these cookies in, okay? Get off there. Now, if you just want to make one big cookie, then you can use this dough and put it in like a cake pan and just push it all down. If you want the batter to be stiffer, all you need to do is throw it in the refrigerator for a good 30 minutes. And then it'll actually stiffen up. Now, we're going to have extra dough. I couldn't help to eat that. That was good. We're going to have extra dough.
Look, it makes perfect little cookie balls.
And we're going to put that in the refrigerator and use it over the past couple days. Because these are, the batter really will last you probably about life shelf in the refrigerator a week. If you want to preserve it, you can put it in the freezer.
Which would be like, what, 6 months?
Well, if it's frozen, I really don't like to let anything stay in there and use it after 6 months. I would prefer like 2 months tops. Yeah. After that, if I use it, I'm not that interested in it, so I'm going to just throw it out.
Yes, I am not that invested no more.
No, I'm not invested. I work hard every motherfucking day, I work hard every day. Shout out to Logic for this everyday song. I like Logic. You turned me on to Logic though, Grayling.
That was actually you that did. Turned me on to Logic.
Remember? Oh, I did?
Yeah, because you was watching like his cypher on BET Awards.
Oh, I was watching the BET
Awards. And then you was like, I want to get his album. And then you got the album.
I thought you knew his Logic before me. Uh-uh. I am hip, huh?
I guess so.
Ooh.
I'm a hermit, you know, remember? Like, I go take pictures in abandoned buildings. And
yes, you do. All right, let's throw these in. Watch out, Draxton. Watch out, Draxton. We're going to put these in. And then we're going to set the timer for 10 minutes. All right. Yes, Craxton, how you doing? Say hi. Huh? Say hi. Say, my name is Draxton.
Mommy.
What's up, baby? Look, I made cookies. Look. Cookie dough.
Look at all that dough.
Yeah, I'm making cookies. Your birthday's coming up. Are you excited?
How old are you going to be?
Say two. He said, can I have some? He ain't bringing something. He wants some cookies. Right, push the button. Now, tip. I like to let mine sit in the oven for an additional 2 minutes. Because the dry heat, I turned the oven off. The dry heat is going to give it a nice little crisp on the top. So, I'm going to wait 2 additional minutes. Hold on. I'm going to sit right there for you. Thank you. All right, now you got you some cookies. And now they need to cool. Don't you touch them cookies, okay? You can't touch them yet. Because then they're not going to be done. But this is how you make the chocolate chip cookies from scratch. And this is how they turn out. And they are delicious. We're going to let them cool because I really want one. But I got to control myself. I'm going to give them this. All right, honey bunny. Pretty good. So glad he approves. TikTok made us do it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button.